two most vital relationships, both of which are held together by trust and by love. And the second relationship that is so important is really to flow out of the first and primary relationship he joined to this man. Jason, do you desire to be united in marriage with Sarah? And will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and be her spiritual leader as long as you both shall live?
I do.
And Sarah, do you desire to be united in marriage with Jason? And will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and be his helper as long as you both shall live? Parents, would you stand just for a moment? Will you, the parents of Jason and Sarah, do all in your power to uphold their marriage in the years ahead? And will you promise to pray for and encourage them that they may fulfill the vows they are making today? Thank you. Let's join our hearts together.
There's another man in her life.
Jason and Sarah don't simply want this.
Signify your willingness to enter into the privileges as well as the responsibilities of holy marriage. These vows are not just your verbal expressions to one another. This is the commitment that you make this day before God who has brought you together. And so, Jason, would you please repeat after me? I, Jason, take you, Sarah, to be my wife. Because of my love for you and the knowledge that God has brought us together, I promise before God, our family and friends, to be your loving and faithful husband, to be a source of encouragement, to comfort and to support you, to pray for and with you, and be your spiritual leader. I promise to love and honor you, using as my example the love which Christ has for the church, in that he loved her and gave himself for her. Sarah, would you repeat after me? I, Sarah, take you, Jason, to be my husband. Because of my love for you and the knowledge that God has brought us together, I promise before God, our family and friends, to be your loving and faithful wife, to be a source of encouragement, to comfort and support you, to pray for and with you, and be your helpmate. I promise to love and honor you, and be subject to you as unto the Lord. You know, a wedding ring is a beautiful symbol of the marriage relationship in at least two ways. The purity of the gold is to symbolize the purity of your love for each other. The unending circle of this ring is to remind you of the unending vows which you just took, which can only be broken honorably in the sight of God by death. And so, Jason, would you take this ring and place it on Sarah's ring finger and repeat after me? Sarah, receive this ring as an outward pledge and symbol of my promise to fulfill these vows which we have taken. With this ring, I thee wed. Sarah, will you take this ring and place it on Jason's ring finger on his left hand? Repeat after me. Jason, receive this ring as an outward pledge and symbol of my promise to fulfill these vows which we have taken. With this ring, I thee wed. Amen. Thank you. Jesus walked upon this earth, on one occasion he said, "I am the light of the world." And he offers and gives an invitation to any one of us to respond to that light. We can come to the Lord Jesus Christ just as we are, sinners separated from him. But when we come to him, Jason and Sarah, inasmuch as you have agreed to enter into the privileges and the responsibilities of holy marriage, it is now a privilege for me, as a minister of the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, to pronounce you husband and wife, and to remind you that what God has joined together, let no man separate. So Jason, if you would like to kiss your bride, you may do so. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege this afternoon to introduce to you, for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jason Ott.
Just a minute, I gotta get my hand fixed. Just a minute, my camera's
doing okay, that's it, you missed it.
For me.
This is the wedding picture.
Okay, I gotta do one more, please.
One more,
because it was the...
Thank you.
love you both out there. You can stay alive for us, I know. Okay, we need to can't do this early. Let's do this proper right now. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, everybody, on your feet, put your hands together, make all kinds of noise for Jason and Sarah Osbeth in here now! All members of the wedding party, on to the next floor, please. All members of the wedding party, right in the room, right out there in the middle. Okay, wedding party and then a circle. Yes. We're getting there, but not quite. All the way around. Right in the middle. In the middle. In the middle. Members of the wedding party, please join hands at this time. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing with total attention on the bride and the groom. Fixate on the bride and the groom. Not that close. Okay. Well, as we all know, we are here in this place today to celebrate with Jason and with Sarah. We didn't come here for the fine food, which was really good. I do believe the staff of the Highmark does deserve a big round of applause right now for that food. And the cake, they did a great job here. And they have a great staff, so we want to thank them for that. But no, we didn't come here for that. And I hate to say this, but we didn't even come here to dance. We came here, Jason did, but no one else. We came here to say, Jason and Sarah, congratulations. We love you. I just met him an hour ago, and I love him. To say, we love you, and we support you. And to further go on with that, what I want to do right now is I'm going to ask each and every one of you to please join me in a pledge of support to the bride and groom. All you have to do is repeat the words that I say to them. And I think they're going to know that it comes exactly from the heart. So please repeat after me, everybody. Jason and Sarah.
Jason and Sarah.
Thank you for letting us be part of your special day.
Thank you for letting us be part of your special day.
No matter where you go.
No matter what you do,
you will always have family and friends that love you.
You will always have family and friends that love you.
And we all wish you,
we all wish you
a wonderful life together.
A wonderful life together.
But
remember one thing.
Next year, you host Christmas. One more time, big round of applause for the bride and groom. Now the next thing is, I don't want to have to do this, but I am held responsible by the state of Nebraska. What I need really quick, Sarah, face Jason, put your right hand out like this. Jason, put your right hand on top of hers. Look deep into her eyes. Can you read what her mind is thinking? Good, I'll tell her. But first, I want you to look at your hand. Yeah. See how it's laying there?
Yeah.
On top of hers? She's thinking that this is the last time he's ever going to have the upper hand on me. That's exactly what she's thinking. Okay. Wedding party, I have you there in a circle, holding hands, right? Holding hands. Because they got up nice and early today. It was an early wedding and everything. And I bet you guys haven't had a chance to give them that group hug you've been wanting to give them all day long, have you? So on the count of three, big group hug. Here you go. One, two, three. Ladies and gentlemen, you may sit down. There was no joy in that group hug. No, join hands again. I went screaming, hollering, and it was a... Final call, single ladies, final call. Song's over. Time to work. But before we do, Jason, I gotta let you know that I was kind of circulating around the room and I didn't like what I heard from these people. I didn't like it at all. Because they said, used to be, before Jason got together with Sarah, he was all manly. Now, I'm not gonna finish. Because I won't do that. I just won't do that. So I want you to prove to each and every one of these people in this room that you are indeed the man, because you're the man, right? Yeah, I'm buying it. So what I want you to do is, as loud as you can, they want mine, as loud as you can, I want you to pick one person out in this room, look at that person, and let them know that you're the man. As loud as you can, I want you to say, I am the man. I am the man! And I wear the pants of the family.
And I wear the pants!
Okay, you've already blown it. Yeah, we're not gonna buy that at all. So I have a backup plan here of how you can show that you are indeed the man. Give me a number between 1 and 10. That's all you have to do. 1 and 10.
3.
3. I'm really doubting you now. He said 3. Okay. Well, before we get to the manly part here, face your bride. Take her in your arms. Say, Sarah, I love you. Say it so we can hear it.
Sarah, I love you.
That's good. Thank you for marrying me.
Thank you for marrying me.
Now, turn sideways. Turn both of you sideways. Both of you. See the photographers right here? I want you to grab your wife there. Give her the biggest kiss you ever have with a dip in it. I want a big dip kiss here for the camera. On the count of three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Dipper. There you go. See? There you go. I got to work for my photo guy here. I got to work for him. Yeah, sure. I've never had a double header. Go for it. That's good. Yeah. A double dip there, that's good, yeah. Great, okay, now put your hands on her shoulders. Say, honey, forgive me.
Honey, forgive me.
Yeah, see, I'm putting words in your mouth now. Spare her 3 times. Good thing you didn't say 9. See, 3. You can't count. That was 5, that's all right. Okay, Sarah, are you dizzy? I could say something really mean now about a dizzy bride, but I'm not going to, because I love you. I said that earlier. All right, on the count of three, we're gonna give this a toss. Ladies, the only rule is it cannot hit the ground. No fighting, no clawing, no scratching. On the count of three. 1, 2, 3, toss. Oh, oh. She stepped on your foot. How nice. Come here. We got a picture for you. You need it for the picture? You want both? Or?
Yep.
We need you for a picture. Need you for a picture. Beautiful. And while we're doing that, as creatively as you can think of, remove the guards from her beautiful head. Can you do it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Wow, I called you still. That's a first call. All right. Here you go.